to help make your holiday dollars work harder. That's why the Home Depot is your home for holiday inspiration. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Sunday, a young DA found murdered.
Stabbed to death.
Now, 5 years later, cold case detectives will retrace his last steps.
He was a good kid. Everyone has a dark side. Graves was pretty dark.
And you won't believe where they'll lead.
If this gets out, it's a Pandora's box.
New Cold Case, CBS Sunday.
Dave's All New with Bill Murray, Monday on The Late Show.
What happened to the little girl? It was never fully explained.
I've always thought that her parents were involved in her murder.
It had to be some either friend or relative involved.
I always felt like they were hiding something.
Because we're the parents, we're the murderers. Is that the thesis? It's sad if that's what we think as a society.
My name is Ollie Gray. I have over 25 years of law enforcement experience.
My name is John St. Augustine. I'm an evidence consultant.
And my name is Robert Peterson. I'm a private investigator.
We have been working on this case since December of 1996.
We've gained more information in the last year than probably the prior 4 or 5 years. We now have evidence that will tell you who the killer is.
I was able to develop a genetic profile that came from a male that was not associated with the case.
What we found was that there were specific DNA samples that pointed to somebody other than the Ramseys.
If our DNA matched anything significant, they would have arrested us in a New York minute.
The DNA is the strongest piece of evidence. Who out there has that DNA?
From the outset, I was fairly convinced that the parents didn't do it. I assumed that it was an intruder.
Would it surprise you if I told you there were almost 40? Registered sex offenders within 2 miles of the Ramsey home?
Not at all, no. In fact, that almost sounds conservative to me. To someone with that kind of a twisted mind, she may have looked like a really good target.
We had a false sense of security about Boulder. We thought it was a nice, quaint, small town.
What I can tell America is there is a sick madman in your midst that you haven't caught yet. Wake up.
JonBenét, Prime Suspects. Tonight's 48 Hours Mystery. Continues in 90 seconds. 48 Hours is sponsored by Zales, the Diamond Store, the Holiday Gift Countdown, reminding you there are only a few days left to buy beautiful diamond jewelry.
When you want to find her just the perfect gift, it helps to know the people who know diamonds. Zales, beautiful half-carat diamond ring, just $149.99. Zales, the Diamond Store. When you want to find her just the perfect gift, it helps to know the people who know diamonds. Zales exquisite 3-carat diamond bracelet, just $499.99. Zales, the Diamond Store.
Gotta go.
For those who never quit, the battery that never quits, Energizer. Keep going.
I need to send this priority mail, so I need a postage, mailing label, and I also need insurance.
Can you do that for me, sweetie?
Yeah.
Thanks, honey.
This holiday season, use USPS.com online shipping. The U.S. Postal Service is working for you.
Tragedy separated two young friends. Now 30 years later, fate will bring them back together. Gary Sinise.
I've been waiting a long time for this.
Fallen Angel, CBS Sunday.
Tuesday, the stars celebrate. Sir Elton John, screen idol Warren Beatty, Star Wars composer John Williams, legendary actors Ruby Dee, Ossie Davis, and more. Caroline Kennedy hosts the TV event of the season, the Kennedy Center Honors, CBS Tuesday.
Boulder, Colorado. On the surface, the ideal American town. It's beautiful, peaceful, and seemingly cut off from the types of crime that infect larger cities. It's no wonder that Boulder attracts successful, affluent families like the Ramseys once were.
We moved to Boulder. We very strongly felt we had moved to a very safe, small, kind of Ozzie and Harriet kind of community.
Tonight, we're going to show you a very different side of this quaint small city. A darker side, made up of a small group of burglars, thieves, and sex offenders, where the answer to Boulder's most notorious unsolved murder may be found. The case of JonBenet Ramsey. There's new evidence that investigators hope will finally lead to a break in the case.
Kidnapping. Hurry, please.
It began 8 years ago, in the early hours of December 26, 1996, with a 911 call from Patsy Ramsey.
Explain to me what's going on, okay?
There, we have a... There's a note left and our daughter's gone.
How old is your daughter?
6 years old. She's blonde. 6 years old. Oh my God, please.
Boulder police responded immediately. And what looked at first like a kidnapping quickly became a murder when the body of JonBenet Ramsey was found by her father in a small storage room in the basement of her house. Because of the bizarre ransom note and the fact that JonBenet was killed in her own home, Boulder detectives focused on her parents, John and Patsy Ramsey, as their prime suspects.
I did not kill my daughter, JonBenet.
Brushing aside the thousands of leads that came in, Boulder police dismissed the possibility that an intruder had somehow slipped into the house and committed the murder. Instead, they leaked information to the media, sometimes fabricated information, to put pressure on the Ramseys.
They convinced the public of guilt.
Lynn Wood, the Ramsey's attorney.
You couldn't go to buy groceries for your family without passing headlines that said that John Ramsey had molested his first daughter. Absolutely false. Headlines that John and Patsy Ramsey were pornographers. Absolutely false. Headlines that they were devil worshipers. Absolutely false.
It's frustrating, it's disappointing, it makes me angry.
Somebody's out here walking on the street. God knows they might do it again to some other child.
Throughout the lengthy and sometimes hostile police interrogations, both in 1998 and 2000.
I'm not here to prove my innocence. I'm here to find the killer of my daughter.
The Ramseys maintained their innocence.
I didn't do it. John Ramsey didn't do it, and we didn't have a clue of anybody who did do it. My life has been hell from that day forward, and I want nothing more than to find out who is responsible for this.
8 years later, investigators not only think that Patsy Ramsey was right, they're no longer even focusing on the Ramsey family.
Detectives working for the district attorney now believe one, possibly two intruders entered the Ramsey home and killed JonBenet. And they are finally concentrating their efforts on the underside of Boulder, which was largely ignored during the initial investigation.
A lot of people don't really think about, let's go find out who's our next door neighbor. It's not until something big happens that we worry about who are our neighbors.
John San Augustine and Ollie Gray, who were originally hired by the Ramseys in 1999, are now part of a small band of private detectives working without pay, determined to find JonBenet Ramsey's killer.
You know, from the get-go, Patsy and John were the focus of JonBenet's murder. And nobody really looked into the intruder theory.
You know, when you start turning rocks over in Boulder, you know, stand back.
What they have discovered is startling. Within a 2-mile radius of where the Ramseys once lived, 38 of their neighbors, 38, are registered sex offenders. What these private detectives have also discovered is that in the months before JonBenet's murder, there were more than 100 burglaries in her neighborhood.
Patsy Ramsey said that she was living with a false sense of security in Boulder. Was she right?
I would say she's right. All the crime that was actually going on, I don't think that the Ramseys had any clue that this was going on.
From the outset, police never seriously considered the evidence that JonBenet may have been killed by someone outside the Ramsey family.
I don't think the Ramseys did it. And I think they ought to start looking for people that did.
Retired homicide detective Lou Smith, who once quit because police ignored the intruder theory, is back on the case. He is once again working for the Boulder DA and can no longer speak publicly, but did speak with 48 Hours in 2002.
This murder was not conducted upstairs in a nice little bedroom. This murder was conducted in the basement, and it was very vicious.
Results from the autopsy showed evidence that JonBenet may have been subdued with a stun gun and then eventually killed with this intricately tied device known as a garrote.
This is one of the best clues left behind by the killer. This is a sexual device. I'm looking for a pedophile that's a sexual sadist. That's what Lou Smith's looking for. This is where I believe that the killer got in. Take a look real closely at the window on the left. What you're going to see is leaves and debris pressed right up against the window. Now let's take a look at the one again in the center. No leaves or debris.
Which says?
That window was open. Directly below that open window, you have a suitcase. Directly around that suitcase, you have leaves and debris.
The current investigation also focuses on the possibility of two intruders, because of two very clear boot prints in the room where JonBenet was found.
You have a high-tech boot and you have an unknown boot. Just based on just that detail alone, you would think that, you know, there's definitely two people involved.
You believe these are at least two intruders?
Absolutely.
And there's another clue investigators are interested in, a rope found in the bedroom next to JonBenet's.
The rope, we don't know who it belonged to. We don't even know how it got there.
It's now a whole new area of the JonBenet Ramsey case. We now have leads that we've never had before.
Did you see this Visa National Treasure promotion? If you win, all of your 2004 Visa purchases could be free. Too bad you didn't buy that much.
Those treasures you've been hiding all year.
Honey, what do you want to do about dinner?
Could be treasure. Use your Visa in November and December this holiday season, and you're automatically entered for a chance to win all of your 2004 Visa purchases. No purchase necessary to enter.
Is that new?
This old thing? And if you want to find more treasure with your Visa, use it to see National Treasure, now in theaters.
I'm a giving person, and Big Lots lets me be me.
Does that feel good?
At the closeout price, you can buy all you want. Beautiful decorations, toys,
garlands, very sparkly. I mean, a $25 Fisher-Price boombox for $15.
I love this.
Why are you decorating my house?
Oh, we're doing the whole street.
The whole street? Who took her to Big Lots in the first place?
Big Lots. Brand names, closeout prices, happy holidays.
I need an elf on the roof.
Want to be an elf?
Elf?
Elf.
Elf.
Wow, looks nice. So your electric bill's gonna be a little higher this month. Just like your family's wireless bill.
Oh, yes.
Well, relax. Only Sprint got rid of ugly overages for families. Take a look.
Protect your family from ugly overages. Now 100 extra minutes only cost $5. Other plans charge at least $35. And unlimited Sprint PCS to PCS calling is included.
And with the money you save, maybe this could be a year-round thing.
Sprint PCS. Now that's better.
How long have we been chasing someone else's idea of beauty? Maybe one size fits all hair doesn't fit you. Rediscover the beauty of your own hair. Discover Dove shampoos and conditioners.
Here we go.
I wanted popcorn chicken.
I wanted crispy strips.
I wanted original recipe.
Introducing the Variety Bucket from KFC. A three-in-one combo of KFC favorites. Four pieces of original recipe chicken, four crispy strips, and one large popcorn chicken. All for just $9.99. There's a new way to please everyone. Only in
Chicken Capital USA!
Does this little stone box have a big connection to Jesus? If so, it's a major discovery. And it's on 60 Minutes Sunday.
Detectives retrace the last steps of a murdered DA.
Everyone has a dark side. Greg's was pretty dark.
What do you think he was hiding?
Don't miss a new cold case, CBS Sunday.
Wednesday.
I wish Santa Claus can find a home for me.
Join host Jamie Foxx and Hollywood's biggest stars for real-life stories of adoption that will touch your heart.
I love my mom and dad.
Plus, musical acts that will bring down the house. A Home for the Holidays, CBS Wednesday.
Do not have sufficient evidence to warrant the filing of charges against anyone who has been investigated at this time.
After a murder investigation that went nowhere, the answer to the question, who killed JonBenet, is likely in this Denver Police Department crime lab.
I believe that the technology of today makes it extraordinarily difficult for a killer not to leave his calling card.
That calling card is a complete DNA profile, and police forensic specialist Gregory LaBerge has one for the man he suspects is the killer of JonBenet Ramsey.
It would be very, very helpful to the investigation to have that DNA matched.
This is what the crime lab has. Two spots of JonBenet's blood found on the underwear she was wearing the night she was murdered, and mixed in with that blood is the DNA of an unknown person. It has taken years to isolate, but forensic scientists in Colorado now believe they have the complete DNA profile of the killer. They know the killer is a male. What they don't know is his name.
Well, right now the DNA profile that's in hand doesn't match anyone associated with the investigation, so that would include the parents.
It could be a criminal from way back then. It could be somebody that just hasn't been caught yet, has never offended.
Private Detective John San Augustine and his partner Ollie Gray are convinced that the DNA sample belongs to JonBenet's killer because of a small amount of matching DNA that was also found under the six-year-old murder victim's fingernails.
It's my understanding that all the DNA analysis that has been done match each other.
Same person.
Same person.
And not the Ramseys.
And not the Ramseys.
Do you think it's going to be DNA that solves this case?
Yes.
Absolutely.
48 Hours has learned that the DA's office is using this DNA profile to investigate several suspects in the case. One of those suspects came to light in a most dramatic way. It was early in 1997. The Boulder District Attorney at that time, Alex Hunter, made a startling announcement.
I want to say something to the person or persons that took this baby from us. The list of suspects narrows. Soon there will be no one on the list but you.
Those words were written by the FBI as part of a strategy to put the killer and any accomplices under pressure.
Either the bad guy would kill himself, or the bad guy would turn himself in.
That strategy may have worked. Just 2 days later, the Boulder Sheriff's Department discovered a man by the name of Michael Helgoth dead in his home, an apparent suicide.
Do you believe Michael Helgoth was involved in JonBenet Ramsey's death?
I think he's somebody that's obviously has to be looked in real carefully.
We were walking along at the end of the day, just calm as could be, and he just casually comes up and says, I wonder what it'd be like to crack a human skull.
John Kennedy knew Helgoth well. They worked together in an auto salvage yard outside of Boulder.
And I looked at him and I thought, whoa, I don't want to have this conversation.
Just a few months before JonBenet's murder, Kennedy noticed a change in Helgoth's attitude.
Mike was pretty happy around late November about him and a partner making a killer deal, and they were each going to make $50,000 or $60,000.
Kennedy didn't think anything of it until he read in newspapers about the ransom note found at the Ramsey home that demanded a curious $118,000, close to the amount Helgoth had said he and his unknown partner would make, a ransom that was never paid to anyone.
Then Christmas comes, and then he's really depressed, and there's no money. And then he said that he wanted to crack a human skull, and then she received a crack in her skull. I felt obligated to go to the police department and tell them what I knew.
John Kennedy provided a very relevant piece of information, in my opinion, that should have been a priority lead for the Boulder Police Department.
I called 10 or 15, 20 times, got no response. So I called sergeants, I called officers, I left messages, no one would call me back.
I got the distinct feeling that they had absolutely no interest in anything that took them away from the theory that John and Patsy Ramsey killed their daughter.
But Ollie Gray and John San Augustine were convinced Helgoth was worth a closer look.
His friends say that he owned several stun guns, that he was a gun nut, and supposedly, through the sources that we talked to, that he used to break into people's houses just for the thrill of doing it.
So you see the stun gun here?
The stun gun is important because Gray and San Augustine believe, from examining autopsy photos, that JonBenet was incapacitated with one at some point during her attack.
In our conversation with some of his friends, they said that he owned two or three different stun guns, and one of the stun guns that he owned had a laser sight on it.
Which was the same type of stun gun you believe was used on JonBenet Ramsey. Right.
Yes.
And you'll notice here, Aaron, that there's the high-tech boot that we later took into possession.
These boots, originally ignored by investigators in Helgoth's home, were later discovered by John Kennedy and passed along to Gray and San Augustine, who believe they are an invaluable clue.
That's the underside of Helgoth's boot right
there. That's correct.
Right.
Oh my gosh.
On the left is the high-tech impression that was made in the ground of that area where JonBenet's body was found. There's no reason for Helgoth's boot to be in the Ramsey home when JonBenet's body is found.
The investigators turned the boots over to the Boulder police, who now claim their investigation showed they were the wrong size for a match. But they have yet to be turned over to the district attorney for further analysis. The private detectives in their investigation also uncovered a number of Helgoth's personal videotapes that they say the sheriff's office ignored.
The videotapes were even more concerning for us because on one piece of video, there's actually coverage of an unsolved murder in Colorado.
The search continues for the person or persons.
That to this day is an unsolved murder. And why would a guy have video coverage of just the news coverage of Ellie Bareilles' death? It's odd.
And what they found next was even more of a concern.
We found videotapes of Hillgoth with one of his girlfriend's children.
And what did this ex-girlfriend tell you?
The ex-girlfriend and he had a major argument over supposedly her coming home and finding the daughter in the bedroom, and he was in bed under covers, and she was on the covers. They had a big fight, and there was temporary restraining orders issued.
But most surprising of all was the nature of Hellgoth's suicide.
The initial investigator said he died with a bullet to what part of his body?
To his head.
Was there any bullet in his head?
Absolutely not.
In fact, Hellgoth's fatal shot was nowhere near his head.
Notice that the gun is found on Michael's right, and he's right-handed. The bullet hole is on Michael's left, and it goes across the body from left to right.
It became really odd to us, and that he would then take the gun and bring it around and then try and shoot himself. It doesn't make sense why you would have somebody commit suicide in that manner.
The investigators were left with only one conclusion.
If he committed suicide, it's the most unusual suicide that I have seen.
Then you're saying if he didn't commit suicide, someone killed Michael Hellgoth?
It sure points that way.
And why would someone want to kill Michael Hellgoth?
If he's one of two people involved in a major death of a small girl, what's the best way to eliminate any, the word getting out that you had any involvement in it? You eliminate your partner.
Was Michael Hellgoth involved in JonBenet Ramsey's murder? And was he killed by a partner for what he knew? Remember that in the Ramsey ransom note, there was the mention of two gentlemen who were watching over your daughter.
If you look at the case real close, you'll see that, quite possibly there was more than one person involved.
One thing investigators are sure of, Hellgoth's DNA does not match the DNA profile sitting in the Denver crime lab.
Investigators must be careful not to put all of the weight in the investigation on the DNA, because the DNA, as important as it is, could be misleading them depending on who it matches or who it doesn't match.
It could mean that if Hellgoth was involved, he wasn't alone, and the person who sexually assaulted and killed JonBenet is still out there.
Are you saying that the killer of JonBenet Ramsey may have tried to do the same thing to another little girl 9 months later?
$3,000 cash back at the mall? A 10-year warranty from Santa? ¥0% financing on a candied yam? Probably not, but you will get all this and more at Kia's year-end sales event. It only happens once a year. Get up to $3,000 cash back. Hurry, offer ends January 3rd.
It's simple. Women remember everything, men forget everything. Exhibit A.
Remember, Kohl's is the place to get your last-minute gifts. You'll find popular video games, fine fragrance minis, 14-karat gold earrings, the LeapPad Plus writing learning system, a Cuisinart 7-cup food processor, or stop guessing and get a Kohl's gift card. There's something for everyone at Kohl's last-minute gift sale.
It's never too late to get a girl gift. Uh-huh.
Fits your list, budget, holiday.
My Sherpa. My equipment. My base camp. My trail. Oh, my Everest. And my favorite part, the descent. My life takes me to the edge. My American Express card always goes with me.
To ship Grandma's present, and it may take a long time, so if you guys behave, I'll get you a surprise.
Will you finally get us a dog?
If you behave the whole time, I'll get you each a dog.
You'll be surprised how fast you can ship packages at the UPS store.
And you're all set.
That's it?
That's it.
No, that can't be it.
That's it.
Want to get in and out fast when you ship holiday gifts? Go to the UPS store.
NFL youth football teaches you skills like teamwork, leadership,
respect, confidence, life skills. Collect them all. Learn more about NFL youth football programs at NFLYouthFootball.com.
Next week, 248 hours on Friday.
Take a picture of me.
I didn't want Parker to be an only child.
Six babies.
Look at the smell.
12,000 diapers.
If I start crying, it's just going to make it worse.
One incredible story.
Hectic, chaotic, stressful.
Really hard.
Six miracles for Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Then on Saturday.
Ask not what your country can do for you.
The Kennedy legacy.
Ask what you can do for your country.
Ultimately, you have to face yourself in the mirror and say, who are you? What have you done?
A generation speaks out about their personal demons.
My addiction was a gift.
A family drama of almost unimaginable scale. Privilege.
Go 110 miles an hour every day.
And pressure.
Tomorrow, you know, it could all be gone.
The Kennedys, next Saturday.
The stars celebrate Elton, Warren, and more at the Kennedy Center Honors CBS Tuesday.
JonBenet Ramsey, and I'm 5'8".
Contestant number 67, JonBenet Ramsey.
If the killer or killers were in fact strangers who hid inside the Ramsey home, how did 6-year-old JonBenet become a target?
She has blonde hair, green eyes.
Investigators Ollie Gray and John San Augustine have a theory of how JonBenet may have been marked for death.
She had just participated in several pageants in the general area.
JonBenet Ramsey.
She had participated in the Christmas parade in Boulder. So, you know, you have seen her.
Number 16, JonBenet.
Patsy and JonBenet kind of enjoyed doing those things as a kind of a mother-daughter thing.
But it was fun. She looked forward to it, and we just had a really fun time.
But investigators now believe that putting JonBenet in the public eye may have inadvertently put her in the sights of a sexual predator as well.
It's like, here's a red flag, Bull, charge it.
She has dark blonde hair and green eyes.
48 Hours has learned that JonBenet may also have been targeted for murder long before she took the stage. Possibly at a local dance studio called Dance West. where she, like so many other little girls, took lessons.
To someone with that, you know, kind of a twisted mind, she may have looked like a really good target.
Less than a year after the murder of JonBenet, former Denver private investigator Pete Peterson was hired to work on another case in Boulder that had strange parallels to the Ramsey case.
There's a Dance West school.
Here we go.
Where the victim of the assault in our case, the one we investigated, and the Ramsey girl both attended.
Peterson now believes that JonBenet could have been targeted at that dance studio because of what happened to his client only 9 months after JonBenet was murdered. Like JonBenet, she took lessons at Dance West. And like JonBenet, this little girl, whom we'll call Amy, was attacked and sexually assaulted at night in her own bedroom. It happened September 14, 1997, on a night when Amy's father was out of town. After catching a movie, Amy and her mother returned home around 10 p.m. What they didn't know when they entered the house was that there was already an intruder inside.
It's very clear this is a very bold intrusion.
This is Amy's father, who spoke to a British documentary crew about what happened that night. To protect his daughter, he asked that his identity be obscured.
My feeling is he got into the house while they were out and hid inside the house. If so, he would have been in there for perhaps 4 to 6 hours hiding.
Before going to bed, Amy's mother turned on the burglar alarm. What happened next is a parent's worst nightmare. Around midnight, Amy woke up to find a man standing over her bed, his hand over her mouth.
What did the little girl remember about the attack?
She remembered the intruder addressing her by her name.
He told her he knew her.
Right. He said, "I know who you are." He repeated those things a few times, apparently. "I'll knock you out, shut up."
My wife heard whispering. She got up, asked if everything was okay. She got a non-committal reply.
From her bed to the child's bed was probably no more than 20 feet at the most, through an open doorway. She proceeded through the doorway, saw this person, and he just brushed her aside.
Startled, the intruder brushed past the mother and quickly made his escape, not through a door, but by jumping out a second floor window.
He was like a ghost that couldn't figure out where he came from or where he went.
By the time the Boulder police arrived, the man was long gone. Because the intruder had gotten in and out of the house so easily, Amy's father began to think, this wasn't the first time he had done something like this.
The first thing that occurred to us was the parallel with the Ramsey case, because it was exactly the same situation.
To the rhythm, kick.
He even told the Boulder police about the Dance West studio connection to the Ramsey case.
I think that someone somewhere drew a bead on her, obviously had us under some sort of surveillance that we were not aware of.
The studio has since gone out of business and been torn down. But this picture shows that there was a balcony overlooking the dance floor where parents and anyone else could come in and watch the children.
There were often people who no one knew their purpose who sat in a gallery kind of a situation and watched the participants.
People could watch? Strangers could watch the girls dance?
Sure.
How?
Well, they could just come in and sit down and observe.
When I told the police about the information I had, they were completely uninterested in it.
How did the family feel about the way the Boulder police dealt with this case?
They were very, very, very frustrated. It was difficult to get them to do anything, much less, you know, beyond taking a report.
But for my wife being a light sleeper, we might be in the newspapers now, as well as the Ramseys. They said, no, this has no similarity at all.
Not only did the Boulder police dismiss any link to the Ramsey case, they didn't even bother to use the mother's eyewitness description to make a composite sketch. That's when the family hired Peterson. And what he has uncovered in his investigation of Amy's assault may not only solve her case, but help lead to the capture of JonBenet's killer as well.
Find great last-minute gifts they can't wait to use. You can at the Home Depot. Right now, 4 days only, get 20% off cordless combo power toolkit purchases of $100 or more. Hurry in for unique gifts at incredible prices. Savings end December 19th. Nobody has more know-how to help make your holiday dollars work harder. That's why the Home Depot is your home for holiday inspiration. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
A renewed sense of confidence has come to the full-size sedan. Introducing the Ford 500. It combines the control of front-wheel or available all-wheel drive with an innovative reinforced structure for precise handling and a secure feeling on the road. The new Ford 500, elevating the sedan. Ford, built for the road ahead.
Fragrance for the holidays. Your gift with any $35 Elizabeth Arden fragrance purchase.
Do you believe in Santa Claus?
Absolutely.
He helped me pick this up.
This holiday, show her you believe in her with the Leo Diamond, handcrafted by the artisans at Leo Schachter. The first diamond to be independently measured and certified for its superior fire, sparkle, and brilliance. And like all diamonds at Kay, every Leo is hand-selected to match beautifully.
Can I give you folks a lift?
Every kiss begins with K.
JonBenet, Prime Suspects. Tonight's 48 Hours Mystery continues in a moment.
Numbers, a new drama coming in January to CBS.
CBS Monday.
What is this?
A bizarre high school prank. Uncovers a dead student.
Was the mob sent to draw us to the crime scene or sent to destroy it?
There must have been 100 of them.
They're called flash mobs. People are contacted by email to show up at a specific time and do something freaky.
Now, the same technology that created the mob.
I got the originator.
Right, give me a name.
Could crack this case.
You'll never believe what I figured out.
Bingo.
Don't miss CSI Miami, CBS Monday.
Whoever killed JonBenet Ramsey could still be out on the streets of Boulder. and stalking other targets.
This person is someone with a huge ego, someone who views himself as bold.
Private investigator Pete Peterson, working on the case of the 12-year-old girl, says there are simply too many parallels to ignore between her case and the murder of JonBenet Ramsey.
Do you believe that the killer of JonBenet Ramsey might have had something to do with Amy's assault as well?
We think there's a decent likelihood.
Both JonBenet and the girl that we've identified only as Amy were sexually assaulted by an intruder in their homes at night within 9 months of each other.
He obviously waited in the house, and then it cost the daughter. Nothing was taken, and nothing else was disturbed.
Fiber evidence shows that JonBenet's attacker may have been wearing black, as was the man who attacked Amy.
Well, this is an intruder, you know, all dressed in black with a reverse baseball cap in black.
And there's the fact that both girls took lessons at the Dance West studio. The Boulder police never found any connections to the murder of JonBenet, but Pete Peterson thinks he has.
And what Peterson found was very disturbing. As he collected evidence in and around the house and did background checks on people who worked in the neighborhood, Peterson found a group of individuals with criminal histories who roamed the neighborhood at night.
Oh, there's somebody.
This is a little shaky. I was laying in a field.
These videotapes were taken by Peterson.
A couple of guys coming out.
What you are looking at
Man.
Are the vehicles that Peterson believes were used by a roving band of criminals.
There's one of the vans they used. We call this the nighttime reconnaissance van. We did tail them at one point within about two blocks from the Ramsey house.
This is some of the area where we conducted nighttime surveillance.
Peterson and his team surveilled this neighborhood for weeks, keeping a close eye on groups of individuals, some with a history of burglary and theft, who seemed to Peterson to be casing the neighborhood.
Where did you get this map?
This belonged to one of the people that we had under surveillance. They were drawing these maps when they were out on their evening journeys around Boulder, nighttime, usually like midnight or beyond.
How did you get this from them?
This was something that they discarded.
What do you think this is?
Oh, I think it's blueprint for burglary at least.
48 Hours has discovered that of Colorado's most dangerous sex offenders, 1 in 8 also has prior convictions for burglary or robbery.
They burglarize and sexual assault if the opportunity presents itself.
And in Amy's neighborhood, the opportunity seemed to present itself quite often.
Approximately in a 1 mile radius of our client's house, I think there have been 19 burglaries and or breaking and enterings in a 2 month period.
Peterson did background checks on his suspects in Amy's case and found a startling revelation. Some of them had at one time worked at the Ramsey home.
Two or three people we were looking at all had associations with both neighborhoods, let's put it that way.
It's one of these suspects, this man, that Peterson has focused on, even going so far as to collect a sample of his handwriting.
We talked to him several times, got handwriting, we had him write something.
Peterson had an expert compare that handwriting to the Ramsey ransom note and claims distinct similarities were found. Still.
You're not saying that there is a match, you're just saying that...
It's an inexact. Handwriting analysis is kind of an art. I mean, it's pretty subjective.
Were you surprised by what you found at night here in Boulder?
Yes, I was. You know, I expected it to be a serene, quiet, safe area. It's fairly serene and quiet, but you find that there's a real undercurrent of activity at night, you know, that... would give me pause for concern if I lived here.
Remember, Peterson is a private detective with no police powers. He's been censored by a judge in the past for how he's gathered evidence. In this case, he's planning to hand over all of his materials to the Boulder DA and can only hope they'll take his theory seriously.
In your heart, do you think these two cases are connected, JonBenet Ramsey and the case that you investigated?
I think there's a really good likelihood, and that's what we're pursuing. We're pursuing that angle still.
But the Boulder DA investigators are continuing to pursue their own leads. People they say are worth a closer look.
You were living in Boulder at the time JonBenet was killed?
Yeah.
Just down the street?
Yeah. About, I don't know, 8 blocks or so, something like that.
Monday, you look different from the last time I saw you.
Stage all new with the very funny Bill Murray.
Are you having trouble breathing?
I am.
Monday.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just to love. What the world needs now is love, sweet love.
Eternity. Eternity for Men. Calvin Klein. Holiday gift sets, now available at the Calvin Klein fragrance counter at major department stores.
With USPS.com, if you can't come to the post office this holiday, the post office will come to you.
Nice.
The U.S. Postal Service is working for you.
When you want to find her just the perfect gift, it helps to know the people who know diamonds. The diamond right-hand ring. Just $299.99. Zales, the diamond store.
Hey, guys.
Welcome home, George.
Presenting the future of grilling. I call it the next grilleration.
All right.
Show us what it can do, George.
Not only is the next grilleration a healthy way to grill, it's a snap to clean up.
Wow. Allow me.
You know, you clean up very nicely.
The next Grilleration George Foreman Grill, now with removable grill plates.
It's not too late to get great holiday deals from Dell. Wrap up someone on your list with this complete Dimension desktop with an Intel Pentium 4 processor. It's yours for the amazing price of $499. Plus, get free 2-day shipping. And right now, pay no interest until 2006 for well-qualified customers. It's only a click or call away. Get more out of the holidays with Dell and get more out of now. Dell PCs use Intel Pentium 4 processors.
For a very long time, John and Patsy Ramsey were the most hated couple in America.
It was like this mass humanity wanting to crucify us.
Our fault was that our daughter was murdered, and we were hated for that.
Boulder police worked almost single-mindedly to try to prove they killed their daughter, JonBenet.
We do not have sufficient evidence to warrant the filing of charges against anyone who has been investigated at this time.
But a grand jury failed to indict the Ramseys, in large part because of one critical piece of evidence, the unexplained male DNA in JonBenet's underwear.
Well, right now, the DNA profile that's in hand doesn't match anyone associated with the investigation, so that would include the parents.
It is, says Denver police scientist Gregory LaBerge, the last and best hope to crack the case.
If the DNA never matches someone, the case, depending on the rest of the investigation, may never be solved.
And now, the same DNA that saved the Ramseys from indictment is finally being used to check out the dozens and dozens of suspects who were ignored for years. 48 Hours has learned that investigators are doing what they call grab and swab. Using a simple cotton swab like this, they're tracking down people of interest and demanding a DNA sample from the inside of their mouths. Those people of interest make up an incredible lineup of misfits and criminals who often have one thing in common, a bizarre fascination with a 6-year-old beauty queen.
This was the infamous globe that came out that had the autopsy photographs in it.
There is this man, who investigators refer to as Candy Cane Man.
Where did this come from?
From the front yard.
From the Ramseys' home?
Yeah.
This is one of the decorative candy canes that lined the Ramseys' front walk on the night of the murder.
And when did you take this from the house?
About a week afterwards.
Why the candy cane?
Because it was there.
But it turns out that some of the canes were missing on the day JonBenet's body was discovered. Investigators fear they may have been taken by the killer or killers as a bizarre souvenir, which led them to this man.
These are all pictures of her performances, stills from videos.
He admits to once having an obsession with JonBenet.
And now this is where you actually had the shrine?
Yeah, it was over here.
He even dedicated a shrine to her that he now keeps on his computer. And there is also his fascination with infamous killers, particularly serial killer John Wayne Gacy.
Well, I have original John Wayne Gacy pictures. Here's one right here, and there's one right there.
This year, he voluntarily gave investigators a DNA sample and was cleared when it did not match the Ramsey crime scene DNA.
I started cutting out some of her pictures. And eventually, I made a little shrine for her.
Another man whom investigators say should have been looked at 8 years ago is Gary Oliva.
When you see the footage of her in her little cowboy suit going, I want to be a cowboy's sweetheart and all that, I've never seen anything like it.
I want to be a cowboy's sweetheart. I want to burn to a fancy ride.
Struck me in a way I've never been struck before.
Out on the great divide.
I believe that she was a genius at the age of six.
48 Hours spoke to Oliva in 2002.
I believe that she came to me after she was killed and revealed herself to me.
He's a convicted pedophile who used to hang around the Ramseys' old neighborhood.
You were living in Boulder at the time JonBenet was killed?
Yeah.
Just down the street?
Yeah. About, I don't know, 8 blocks or so.
Oliva was clearly obsessed with JonBenet Ramsey. Here he is seen at a candlelight vigil held shortly after her death. What's more, 4 years later, when he was arrested for drug possession, police found a stun gun in his backpack.
Did you ever use that stun gun on a child?
No.
I have to ask you this, though. Did you hurt or kill JonBenet Ramsey?
No. No, I didn't.
Oliva has also provided a DNA sample which, again, does not match evidence in the Ramsey case.
They told me I'm clear.
But in fact, the Boulder District Attorney investigators have not completely ruled anyone out and have a list of people they'd like to talk to, reportedly more than 100 names.
There's just so many people. They're all alphabetical, every one of them.
It's a list that still includes Gary Oliva and anyone who can shed more light on the mysterious death of Michael Helgoth. And that includes their friends and associates, whom investigators strongly consider people of interest.
There's a lot to do. It's going to take a group of investigators to go out there and pound the pavement, find out who legitimately could have killed JonBenet.
It's frustrating, but there's been considerable progress. As we've reported tonight, there's now what is believed to be a complete DNA profile of JonBenet Ramsey's killer, an unknown male. There's strong evidence that he may have had an accomplice and that he may have tried to kill again. The city of Boulder is really no different than any city in America, with its fair share of crimes and the usual suspects who commit them. But Boulder authorities have never bothered to look closely at these suspects until now. And with only 2 part-time investigators currently working with the district attorney, it could take years to finally answer the question, who killed JonBenet?
Thank you.
Happy Holidays from Dave and the Late Show. Monday, don't miss the very funny Bill Murray. Dave's all new all this week. Now your local news.